Hello, I'm Elizabeth Lolli, Superintendent of the Dayton Public School District. And today on Straight Talk with Superintendent Lolli, we're going to be discussing school-based health clinics. I'd like to have my guests introduce themselves so we know who's here to have this conversation.
I'm Mohammed Alhamdani, I'm a Dayton School Board member.
I'm Dr. Angie Nichols, I'm the Chief of the Office for Exceptional Children.
I'm Gina McFarlanell, I'm the CEO of Five Rivers Health Centers.
I'm Dr. William Harris, and I'm president of the Board of Education.
Well, thank you all for being here today. I look forward to the conversation that we're going to be having. The board member, Alhamdani, requested early last school year that we start to look at the opportunity for school-based health clinics in our schools. He brought that idea forward to the Board of Education, and they were very excited about that chance to have that conversation. So in September of 2018, Mr. Alhamdani started a committee of our healthcare partners and several staff members, as well as some board members. So could you talk to us a little bit about what a school-based health clinic actually is?
So our vision for a school health school-based health clinic was really built on the idea of what was happening in Cincinnati, especially in the Euler School. We really wanted to have a full-service clinic, one that does physical health, mental, vision, and dental, that will address the health needs of all our students, but potentially also our families and our community. This was a promise that many of us made when we were running for school board. As you are well aware, many of our students live in what we call healthcare deserts without access to healthcare. So it was very important to all of us on the school board that we had a center that addressed those issues for our students. I will leave the rest of what a healthcare center does to our healthcare expert here.
What school-based health centers do is take care of the child, take care of the family, really treat that child as if they are the center of care. And we're excited about the opportunity to partner with Dayton Public Schools in this new venture.
We're excited for the opportunity as well. Mr. Alhamdani, can you talk about the process that the committee went through in order to determine what Dayton Public Schools school-based health center should look like and what they could look like?
Sure, we began with a wide net of potential partners. As you can recall, I think our first meeting must have had 20 different partners in there, including Five Rivers, but we had the health department, CareSource, Children's Hospital. We had a few board members, Mr. President Harris, Jocelyn Reinhardt. We had a few staff members, including Dr. Nichols, yourself, and I think Dr. Byrne was also involved. We had members of every company that was there, also had different members from different departments attend. And we really kind of went through a visioning center of what we wanted to have in our school health-based center. We went out on visits to several different healthcare centers around here that addressed these that were potential for us to copy from and steal from. We were not shy about stealing ideas from other folks, so we went on a couple trips. And in the end, we really kind of liked the idea of having that what Gina kind of labeled as the Cadillac model of healthcare centers for schools, which is to provide full service for our students. After that, we kind of had a smaller knit group of all internal folks, including Dr. Lolli, myself, the president, Dr. Nichols, about, well, which potential partner would be the best for us to work with. And you were the winner, Gina, so we were glad to have picked you, and we're glad to move together on this very, very exciting adventure for all of us.
Thank you. Dr. Harris, why is the board interested in school-based health?
I think the board is interested in school-based health is because we have looked at the total child in terms of holistically looking at the needs of our community, not just academic, but we know that when our students are impacted by certain ills, that they can't learn and they can't receive the information that they should. So we wanted to look at the whole child. We wanted to provide those wraparound services for them so that they will have adequate health care and be ready to learn. And so we wanted to reach out to all of our students and make that available for them, be it dental, as our board member Alhamdani has suggested, in terms of a totality to make sure that their needs are met. And we think it's critical and it's important. They deserve it. And we're glad that this opportunity is available for all of us.
Thank you. Dr. Nichols, we already have a full nursing staff in the district. How will this support the work that our nurses do every day in our school buildings?
We do have a full staff of nurses in every one of our buildings, and they are going to continue to meet the needs, the everyday needs of our students. They will also, they do have issues that come up where we have students who need follow-up care in some capacity, and some of our parents are able to get that care and some of our parents are not. So for those students who need some follow-up, they will be one of the primary individuals who assess that student's needs and make those referrals to our school-based health clinic. And so some of those things might include immunizations. It may include students who fail vision screenings and need to go to our vision center. And to get glasses or whatever they may need in that respect. It may be something like pink eye. It could be just a continuous illness that they have and they really need to see, get some follow-up care. So they will be supported in that role, and so I think it will be a mutual benefit for one another. The two of them, our school-based health clinic and our nurses will work together to service all of our students.
And the district's actually committed to purchasing vans to transport students from different buildings. The new center is going to be housed at the new Roosevelt Elementary School, which is where the Dayton Boys Prep Academy currently is. And in that new center, we'll need to be able to transport students from a variety of schools whenever the nurses suggest that the child comes to the health-based clinic. So the district has actually committed to hiring drivers and vans to be purchased to be able to do that. Gina, could you talk a little bit about what Five Rivers Health Center's role is in this process?
Well, again, thank you for asking me to join this great group of people who have been just as excited about school-based health centers as we have been. We've been just wondering when the great opportunity will be for students within this community to have some of the same services that our neighboring counties have had. And so Five Rivers Health Centers has been around for the past 8 years. We just celebrated our anniversary this week. And it gave us an opportunity to expand from the current primary care services we have to do school-based health centers. And so with the school-based health center, we will have on location a nurse practitioner, sometimes there'll be a physician, we'll have a dentist, we'll have dental hygienists, we'll have dental assistants, we'll have a vision as well as a behavioral health consultant. And the goal is for us to provide that wholesome care for that child, as well as for the families, as well as any staff members in any of the buildings too as well. The goal is to be comprehensive and again to provide that Cadillac services. Not all school-based health centers across Ohio have that four level of care, vision, behavioral health, medical, and dental, but we wanted to make sure that we had it within the Dayton Public Schools area. We know that one of the things that Cincinnati has found is that if we're able to keep children well, they can return to school, they don't miss their classes, they don't miss their tests, they don't spend a lot of time in a nurse's office because, you know, maybe the parent wasn't able to pick them up. But if we can take good care of them and the fact that you're providing transportation to get them to this particular site, I just think we're just setting ourselves up for success for the entire organization, for both of us.
Can families be served?
Absolutely. Our goal is primarily starting with the children who are throughout the entire school districts, but we're also here to serve the families too as well.
Okay. Mr. Alhamdani, I know that because this school-based health clinic is actually in a school, how will the district make sure that children are safe? Because there'll be a lot of traffic in and out of that building, sure. In and out of that area. What did the committee do to make sure that the safety of the students that are actually attending school at Roosevelt will be secured?
So one of the things we made sure is involved our facilities department right away to make sure that as part of the planning for this center that we keep security in mind, There will be a separate entrance for the public to be from the outside. All students will be able to enter from a different side. And then we are taking very extreme measures to ensure that when students are being served, nobody else can get in. The access to in and out will be by ID only with adult supervision. So we're taking extreme measures to make sure that all our students are protected. We're also taking extreme measures to make sure our kids also get there. So when it comes to, we're hopefully planning also dental visits for our students, and we'll have rounds for different schools, and we'll have busing for that as well as vision tests for every student in the district. So this was an approach to make sure that not only are we taking care of them health and mental and dental and vision, but we're also making sure security is part of that whole planning. So, you know, we've as a district have taken steps to ensure that you guys have the space, but we're also going to make sure the build out is safe for our students and that they're being protected.
Dr. Harris, do you think this will be the only school-based health clinic that we'll actually have in the district, or does the board have the vision of additional ones being added?
We certainly do have the vision to have those services at other locations. We're really excited about what's going to happen, however, at this first location. We think it's going to be a tremendous success, which will be evident in our community. And I think they will, our community will want other opportunities to serve. So I'm looking forward to what's going to happen. I'm looking forward to advancement. So Dr. Lolli, you can be assured that those services will be taken advantage of, and I think we will have to make available other funds to make this process continue.
Well, yes. I think the board has been committed to not only healthcare, but we really want to do wraparound services and social services. It's the next step. I mean, this is where the next step is in schooling. Our families live in a lot of neighborhoods that lack a lot of basic services, including food and healthcare, but there are other services. I mean, when we visited Cincinnati, one of the services we saw was, for example, is one of the schools actually had a laundromat there for their students to use and their families to use. They had a social worker that connected not with the students, but with the family members to help with job training and job access. And so those are services that are available in our community. We just have to kind of make sure those services are wrapped around here as well. And so those, that could be next potential growth with us asking for more money, I guess. And as the president and the superintendent smiling, looking at me, like, what else are you asking me for here?
The board recently actually approved 10 positions for behavioral mental health specialists in schools to actually treat students and work with students who need those types of services, in addition to the school-based health clinic. So it's an important step forward. We had 5 social-emotional consultants who worked in our elementary buildings supporting teachers in understanding how to deal with children who might be suffering from traumatic experiences or who might need some extra supports. But this will actually allow us to have someone who actually works inside the building in cooperation with parents, in cooperation with other behavioral mental health specialists that both Five Rivers Health Centers provides, Children's Hospital provides. So we're looking forward to actually having personnel right on site. If you were a parent, and I know you are currently a parent in our schools, Mr. Alhamdani, how would you feel about having the types of services that the district's putting in place for your child? The school-based health clinic right there on site, behavioral mental health specialists, social-emotional learning opportunities for the child and for the teacher. How would you feel about that if your child was still in school today, Dr. Harris?
I would really be so appreciative of all of these services, because many of our families need that service, and it's a help for parents. It's a security. I'm just going to use the word, it's a blessing to have these services available, especially in light of what we just experienced in Dayton on Monday evening. And so I believe, especially the mental health piece, so many of our families experience trauma in different ways, and I think it's really going to be an advantage. And if, and since I am a parent or a graduate of two young people, if I had little ones, I would be thrilled.
And I think for parents who have younger, you know, with my kids being 4 and 2 years old, they get sick a lot, you know? So if, you know, if there was a preschool that had a health clerk or an elementary school, oh man, I'd enroll them in that right away, right? Because, I mean, one of the things that, you know, as busy adults and most of our families, most of our parents are working multiple jobs just to keep up with the demands of today's society. Taking that away from them, you know, the idea that, you know, if your kid gets child, you could just drop them off at school is a great help. And I'm looking forward to the day when it's expanded to almost every school if possible, because then you could just drop your kid off at school and not have to worry about taking them to the doctor. I mean, that's a great help.
As an organization, that's one of the things we really pride ourselves in, being a one-stop shop for our patients. And so over the years, we just had medical, but we grew to behavioral health, dietitian services, pharmacy services, psychiatric services, behavioral health. We offer free fresh fruit to all of our patients too as well. And one of the things that we've just learned is that the more we can do for our patients that gives them like a leg up, it's just one less thing for them to worry about. Yes. And that's what our dream is with the school-based health center, is to be able to give one less thing for patients or the parents of our patients, the children, not to have to worry about their glasses or, you know, did they have their annual dental cleaning, or, you know, that cavity that's been bothering them for a while, we can take care of that. Or, hey, I didn't get a chance to get all the immunizations done, we can handle it. Our goal is not to replace their primary care provider, but just to help out where needed.
Excellent. Dr. Nichols, you actually had experience with school-based health clinics in a previous district where you worked. What kind of benefits and opportunities did you notice that happened with the families that were served?
Well, some of the things that stand out in my mind from having that experience, we had a lot of students who simply had vision issues. They needed a pair of glasses. Often they would come to school and lose the glasses, or they left them at home, or whatever it may be. So we were able to easily refer those students, provide transportation over to the vision clinic. They would get their glasses, get them fitted, and oftentimes we were able to provide two pairs of glasses, one for home and one for school, so that when they came to school, there wasn't the excuse of, oh, I forgot them at home. The teacher would say, oh, I have a pair for you. And our children could see, and they were ready to learn, they were ready to go. So that was a great benefit. And then if we had students who had toothaches, there's nothing worse than a toothache. I know as an adult, there's nothing worse than that. For children, it's even more significant, and they can't focus on what's being taught in the classroom. So we were able to make those referrals and make them quickly and get those students taken care of. So they were back in the classroom and ready to learn. And that's what we need here, here in Dayton as well. The other piece that we're excited about is the behavioral health and the mental health. We have a lot of mental health needs in our communities. And so we're excited to have that opportunity to get additional support for our students, because that is certainly a need that we have.
Well, today we've talked about school-based health clinics, and we specifically have talked about the opening of the new Five Rivers Health Center's school-based health clinic at the new Roosevelt Elementary. Parents who are interested in actually having their child attend Roosevelt, there are a few spots still available, and you can ask for your child to be transferred to that particular building if you're interested in attending Roosevelt Elementary. We're excited about the opportunity, we're excited about the partnership, and we look forward to the great results that we're going to have. Thank you for tuning in today.